Hello everyone and welcome back to my playlist of pharmacology. We are doing drugs which are used for urologic disorders, and today we are going to discuss those drugs which we use for BPH, benign prostatic hyperplasia. आपको इसकी pathogenesis मालूम है, so today the drugs we will discuss. और तीन group of drugs हैं which we use for treating BPH. BPH में one of the major problem is, एक तो ये कि urethra pass out हो रहा है ना, और इस urethra के इर्द-गिर्द there is prostatic tissue. So इसकी BPH की pathogenesis का एक part तो physiological mechanism है, जिसमें overactivity of the parts of the glands hai. As a result, we have more dihydroxy testosterone formation from testosterone. So this is the physiological issue which we have in the BPH. Another issue is the mechanical issue. The mechanical issue is once there is hyperplasia, and this hyperplasia leads to obviously enlargement of the gland, and as a result of the enlargement of the gland, the urethra is compressed. So urine flow ka issue hota hai. So if urine flow is problematic, that is the mechanical issue. So teen tarah ki jo drugs hum use karenge is BPH ke treatment ke liye, that is going to be alpha adrenergic antagonists. That's the first class. और इस ग्रुप का मैं आपको एक जेनरिक अभी से काम बता देता हूँ, फिर आगे इसको डिटेल में तो हम पढ़ेंगे ही. दिस ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रग एक्चुअली रिलैक्सेस, एज द नेम इंडिकेट, अल्फा एड्रेनर्जिक एंटागोनिस्ट हैं. तो यहाँ प्रोस्टेट में देर आर अल्फा वन रिसेप्टर्स, एंड देन देर आर डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज ऑफ अल्फा रिसेप्टर्स, अल्फा ए रिसेप्टर्स, अल्फा डी रिसेप्टर्स. वील टॉक अबाउट दैम इन अ मिनट. बट दीज अल्फा रिसेप्टर्स आर ब्लॉक्ड. इनके ब्लॉक करने से होता ये है कि स्मूथ मसल रिलैक्स होते हैं, स्मूथ मसल्स इन द प्रोस्टेट. वो टिश्यू जब रिलैक्स होता है ओवरऑल, देन द यूरिनरी जो ब्लॉकेज था वो रिलैक्स होता है. सो देर इज फ्री फ्लो ऑफ यूरिन. सो दैट इज द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन फॉर अल्फा वन एंटागोनिस्ट. देन देर इज अनदर कैटेगरी विच इज 5-alpha reductase inhibitor. It basically inhibits this step, testosterone ki conversion into dihydroxytestosterone. Dihydroxytestosterone is stopped, and you know this is very potent. And once this conversion is blocked, to overall jo prostate hai uska size shrink ho jata hai, because the physiology is all blocked here na. And then the last category is the phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitor. इसमें सिर्फ एक ही drug है which is approved, which also causes smooth muscle relaxation, and that is tadalafil. So तीन categories हैं drugs की. सबका काम basically overall यही है कि somehow reduce the pressure effect of the prostate. Otherwise तो surgery करके आप निकालते ही हैं prostate in BPH patients. But pharma-wise जो आपको drugs याद रखनी है वो तीन classes हैं. One is the adrenergic antagonist alpha 1, the second one is 5-alpha reductase inhibitor, and the third one is phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitor. तीनों ही काम basically mechanical relief कर रहे हैं urine obstruction का. Okay? So अब एक एक करके तीनों के बारे में पढ़ते हैं. The first group of drug is alpha adrenergic antagonist. इस class में zosyn वाली drugs हैं, terazosin, doxazosin, tamulosin, alfuzosin. So remember zosyn. Okay? Now ये जो सारी drugs हैं, जो भी मैंने नाम लिए, they are selective, competitive blocker of alpha 1 receptor, because alpha receptor ki bhi kai categories hain. So they are all blocking particularly alpha 1 receptor. All 5 agents are indicated for the treatment of BPH. Prazosin is an alpha blocker that is used off label. Ye waise ab use karte bhi nahi hai, kind of khatam ho gayi hai ye drug, because we have better drugs now, right? How do they perform their mechanism of action? Maine already aapko yahan pe ek brief sa hint diya tha ki prostate में there are alpha 1 receptors, and by blocking these receptors, smooth muscle relaxation होती है. So let's read about it. Alpha 1A receptors are found in the prostate, so specifically in the prostate. Alpha 1B receptors are found in the prostate as well as in the vasculature. तो ये बड़ा important point है, क्योंकि अगर आप alpha 1B receptor blockers use कर लेते हैं या non-specific alpha blockers use करते हैं, तो vasculature में भी smooth muscles की tone कम होगी, and that may lead to hypotension. So this is one of the side effect of general usage of alpha blockers. And then there is alpha 1D receptors which are found only in the vasculature, not in the prostate. So if you block alpha 1A and alpha 1B receptors, which are both present in prostate, there will be relaxation of smooth muscle in the prostate, but alpha 1B ka effect vasculature pe bhi hoga. Okay, और जब स्मूथ मसल रिलैक्स होंगे देन देर इज इंक्रीज्ड यूरिन फ्लो बिकॉज द ओवरऑल पैथोजेनेसिस यू नो इज द प्रेशर इफेक्ट ऑफ द प्रोस्टेट इनलार्जमेंट ऑन द यूरिन फ्लो. सो अगर मैं स्मूथ मसल्स को यहाँ रिलैक्स कर देता हूँ देन देर विल बी इम्प्रूव्ड यूरिन फ्लो. ओके, डॉक्सिसोसिन एंड टेराजोसिन एंड अल्फाजोसिन ब्लॉक अल्फा 1A एंड 1B रिसेप्टर्स वेयर एज टैमुलोसिन एंड साइलोडोसिन आर मोर सिलेक्टिव फॉर अल्फा 1 ओनली. सो यू शुड हियर एंटिसिपेट कि अगर आप ये ड्रग्स यूज करेंगे जो कि अल्फा 1A रिसेप्टर ब्लॉकर हैं पर्टिकुलरली, सो दिस इज नाउ अंडरस्टैंडेबल कि अगर आप वो ड्रग्स यूज करते हैं जो अल्फा 1A रिसेप्टर्स को सिलेक्टिवली ब्लॉक करते हैं सो दे विल नॉट कॉज हाइपोटेंशन. हाउएवर अल्फा 1B रिसेप्टर ब्लॉकर्स विल कॉज हाइपोटेंशन एज अ साइड इफेक्ट एज वेल. ओके, सो दे विल ऑल्सो डिक्रीज द पेरिफेरल वैस्कुलर रेजिस्टेंस एंड दे विल लोअर द आर्टेरियल ब्लड प्रेशर एज वेल. सो यू शुड नाउ अंडरस्टैंड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट बिकॉज दे आर मोर सिलेक्टिव फॉर अल्फा 1A विच इज प्रेजेंट स्पेसिफिकली ऑन प्रोस्टेट एंड नॉट ऑन द वैस्कुलेचर. सो सिंपल बात यह है कि वी यूज अल्फा 1A ब्लॉकर्स, वी कैन यूज अल्फा 1B ब्लॉकर्स, बोथ ऑफ देम आर प्रेजेंट ऑन प्रोस्टेट बट अल्फा 1B इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट ऑन वैस्कुलेचर. सो एनीथिंग विच इज ब्लॉकिंग अल्फा 1B will also cause smooth muscle relaxation of the blood vessel and as a result of this there will be hypotension. Okay, so if you look at the side effect chart, orthostatic hypotension, particularly if you are using alpha 1B receptors, tachycardia, vertigo, these are all related to hypotension, headache and maybe fatigue, right? So these are common side effects. सो एडवर्स इफेक्ट्स पहले पढ़ लेते हैं फिर फार्माकाइनेटिक्स दे बताता हूँ. अल्फा ब्लॉकर्स में कॉज डिजीनेस, लैक ऑफ एनर्जी, नीजल कंजेशन, हेडेक, ड्राउजीनेस, हाइपोटेंशन बिकॉज टैमुलोसिन एंड साइलोडोसिन आर मोर इफेक्टिव ऑन अल्फा 1, सो दे आर वेरी मच सिलेक्टिव. दे यूजुअली हैव मिनिमल यू नो साइड इफेक्ट्स पर्टिकुलरली रिलेटेड टू द ब्लड प्रेशर. Okay, by blocking alpha 1 receptors in the ejaculatory duct, impairing smooth muscle contraction, inhibition of ejaculation and retrograde ejaculation have been reported. So these drugs use may be associated with you know pregnancy issues. So you know there is ejaculation moving forward, the semen uske liye bahut important hai, smooth muscle contraction, but now you are giving smooth muscle relaxants, so there can be an issue, right? Several of these agents have a caution about floppy iris syndrome as well because you also have, you know, that's basically a condition where iris billows in response to intraoperative eye surgery because it becomes floppy, there are smooth muscles in there and the blockers may have affected iris as well. So, blood pressure related side effects, reproduction related side effects, ejaculation ke issues and iris related side effects. Teen categories hain jo aapko yaad rakhni hai, okay? अब ये जो ड्रग्स हैं इनकी फार्माकोकाइनेटिक्स, दे आर वेरी वेल एब्जॉर्ब्ड आफ्टर ओरल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, यानी टैबलेट्स आप खाते हैं. व्हेन टेकन विद फूड द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ दीज ड्रग्स इज इंक्रीज्ड. देयरफॉर फॉर बेस्ट एफिकेसी दीज एजेंट्स शुड बी टेकन विद फूड और इमीडिएटली आफ्टर अ मील. डॉक्सिसोसिन, अल्फाजोसिन, टैमुलोसिन एंड साइलोडोसिन आर मेटाबोलाइज थ्रू द साइटोक्रोम P450 सिस्टम. सो दिस मीन्स कि एनी ड्रग इंट्रैक्शन और एनी इनहिबिशन और ओवर एक्टिविटी ऑफ साइटोक्रोम P450 सिस्टम विल ऑल्सो अफेक्ट द मेटाबॉलिज्म ऑफ दीज ड्रग्स. साइलोडोसिन इज अ सबस्ट्रेट फॉर PGP विच इज पी ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन. टेराजोसिन इज मेटाबोलाइज्ड इन द लिवर बट नॉट थ्रू द CYP450 system. So this is important because if you are taking these drugs in association with those drugs which can affect cytochrome P450 system, then ye wali to aapko chhodni padengi, but ye aap phir bhi le sakte hain because ye is system se metabolize hi nahi hoti. Okay, peak inka effect in 1 to 4 hours and if there is kidney issues, some of the drugs may have to be adjusted. General principle hai pharmacology ka, no big deal. So that was one group of drug called alpha adrenergic antagonists. So now I hope you have understood them completely. Okay, how do they work? What are the side effects? And what is the pharmacokinetic profile? Now let's talk about some of the drug interaction. जब कभी ये cytochrome P450 का नाम आ जाए तो drug interaction बड़ी important हो जाती है, right? So drugs that inhibit the CYP3 A4 system, yeah, CYP2D6 system, and you should know the example, some of the important calcium channel blockers may increase the plasma concentration of these drugs because the metabolizing system is now affected. Whereas drugs that induce the CYP450 system, such as phenytoin, yeah, warts, viral, carbamazepine, they may decrease the plasma concentration. Alfuzosin may also increase the QT interval, not good for heart patients. Because psilocybin is a substrate for P-glycoprotein, drugs that inhibit P-glycoprotein, such as cyclosporin, may increase this, the systemic concentration of psilocybin because this system is now affected. So all these drug interactions are to be remembered for your examination purposes, right? The next category of drug is the 5-alpha reductase inhibitor, or its mechanism of action. I have already told you that the conversion of testosterone into DHT, which is very potent, this is blocked by this group of drugs. And once this is blocked, the overall size of the prostate shrinks, and therefore reducing the physical effects of prostate compression of the urethra. The drugs include finasteride, Deuterostatide, they inhibit 5-alpha reductase. Ek important baat yahan pe ye hai ki ye jo group of drug hai, inka effect dikhne mein aata hai. I mean, it takes so many months for their effects to be visible on the patient of BPH. They may take up to 12 months as compared to just a few days with the alpha-1 antagonist. How do they work? Both finasteride and deuterostatide, they inhibit this enzyme 5-alpha reductase, which is responsible for converting testosterone into DHT. You know, already aapko video ke start mein bata chuka hu. Now, DHT, you know, is an androgen that stimulates the prostate growth, and once this is blocked, the size of the prostate goes down. That's how it works. Okay? Inke working algorithm mein, aapko obviously jab bhi kisi drug ki baat karte hain, pharmacokinetics is important. So food does not affect absorption of these drugs. You know, this is in contrast with the previous group, jahan food improve kar raha tha absorption of those drugs, alpha 1 antagonist ki. Both agents, yani finasteride and deuterostatide, are highly protein bound and metabolized by CYP450 system. The mean plasma elimination half life is 6 to 16 hours. If you can remember, it's good for you, otherwise that's fine. While the terminal elimination half-life of deuterostatide is 5 weeks. So basically, ye long term wali drugs hain. Inka effect hi, you know, mahino mein nazar aata. Adverse effects kya honge? The 5-alpha reductase causes sexual side effects such as decreased ejaculate, decreased libido, even gynecomasia, oligospermia. So they have serious consequences. Finasteride and deuterostatide also are teratogenic, so one has to avoid this during pregnancy, particularly in the initial trimester. Women who are pregnant of childbearing age should not handle or ingest either of the agent, even should not handle. This is very important. Okay. Although both agents are metabolized by CYP450 system, drug interactions are rare. Now that's a rare scenario. Aisa usually hota nahi hai, but in case mein keh rahe hain, to maan lete hain bhai baat. Now, jo last group of drug hai, wo hai phosphodiester. Isse pehle yaar ek table, wo kahan hai? Yeah, this table. Ye main discuss karna cha raha tha. So, ek category of drug ye hai, alpha-1 adrenergic antagonist, jisme zosin wali drugs hai. The second category is the finasteride category, which is 5-alpha reductase inhibitor. In mein hai, ye sari important points hai, zara isko go through karte hai. So, decrease in prostate size. We know that finasteride causes it because it blocks the conversion of testosterone into dihydroxytestosterone. So, ye jab block hoga, to size kam ho jayega. So, yes, it reduces the size of prostate. It does not, because it just causes vascular and agar vascular tab jab hum alpha-1B ki baat kar rahe hain, agar hum prostate ki baat kar rahe hain, so alpha-1A. So, prostate is smooth muscle relaxation, but no change in size. Peak onset is in few weeks, but that is months. Decrease in PSA, no, but yes with 5-alpha reductase inhibitor. Sexual dysfunction dono mein hai, but with this group zyada hai. Hypotensive effect sirf is category ka hai, in drugs ka hypotensive effect nahi hai, because they don't work on smooth muscles of the blood vessel. So this should make sense to you. Commonly used drugs are these, and here finasteride and deuterostatide. So ye do categories, kyunki ye dono bahut commonly used hone wali drugs hain BPH ke liye, inka ek common comparison aapko pata hona chahiye. Jo last category hai, usme sirf ek hi drug FDA approved hai for BPH, that is tadalafil. Now, phosphodiesterase 5 is present also in the prostate as well as in the bladder. And if you inhibit this, such as by tadalafil, it shows vasodilation and relaxation of the smooth muscle of the prostate as well as bladder. Therefore, it improves the urinary flow in BPH, and that's it. So, three categories of drugs that are used in BPH, and we discussed all three of them. Usually, we use first two groups alpha 1 adrenergic antagonist versus 5 alpha reductase inhibitor. So, inke differences aapko clearly pata hone chahiye. So, with this, I'll end the video here and I'll see you in the next video very soon. Take care of yourself. Have a nice weekend.